Hey, what's up guys, this is Point Man, and this is a Fall of Samurai video just to show you a little bit more concept about mind games. Now this will be all about educational purposes. Just gonna press play real quick. You can see my opponent is in the white banners. His name is Frosty of the Wars. This was a part of the a Beta Flash tournament. It was the Russians, they hosted it, and I really don't want to talk about this tournament because I didn't enjoy it that much, but this was pretty much my first match, even though my opponent in the first round conceded, and in the I think this was the second round, so yeah, this is the second round of the tournament. And you can see our builds add 2 Kisho Ninja, 3 Shogatai, 2 Black Tortoise Force. On this side of the battlefield, I have 2 Shogun and Guard Cav, they're vanilla. I have my Bushido slash Gungeon, and on this side I have 3 Yariki. He has on this side 1, 2, 3 Yariki, and they're all decently upgraded, like 16 melee attack. I guess he didn't use practice grounds, that way they would have had 18. He has looks like 3 red bears in the front, so he is pretty much a Gungeon because they have reload, increased capabilities on reload, accuracy, ammo, and in reserve he has 2 spear levy. On this side he does have 2 Imperial infantry and a spear levy. And for Cav, he does have 2 Revolver Cav and 1 Carbine Cav. So it's a really nice build that he brought, very balanced. He has some spears, guns, and Cav, gun Cav, and everything. So he pretty much has a nice build that would literally counter mine, because Revolver Cav, they would decimate my Kisho Ninjas, my melee, my Cav, and everything if I don't use them properly, or if I blindly just charge him straight ahead. So at this point of the battle, I'm just going to take a screenshot real quick, and then we could carry on with the rest. So at the moment I really wanted to push this side, but with guns and Cav it's really not an option. So my only choice was to push over here. Now really experienced players like Ducky, I could name a few at the very top of my list, like Ducky, Killerfish, Prussian Prince, Sareept, and a bunch of other YouTubers like Majutsu, Unicorn Attack. They all know about mind games, and they all know, they could just look at your build, and if you have any hidden units, they'll practically tell you what you have in that forest that you're hiding. They could tell by the way, they know the price of all these units, and when you see an army for so long, you could probably add that total up in your head. You could probably be like, okay, he has 3 Shogatai, so that's 3k right there. They're all vanilla, so he has like more upgrades on his Cav. His Cav are most likely going to be over like 1.1k or something like that. So like mine are like 1130 Koku or 1180. That means they have like 6 upgrades. So yeah, you can pretty much do the math in your head if you're good at it. So I was kind of worried that he would realize that, oh wait a second, he doesn't have any upgrades on his Shogun Guard Cav or his Shogatai or his Black Tortoise Force or any other thing. The only thing I really have good upgrades on is my Yariki. So I figured he would notice that and notice that I have something hidden, which are my Kisho Ninja. Kisho Ninjas are very expensive. They're 990 Koku each, and I have only 2. I didn't want to overdo it. That's how most people know you have ninjas, because you have a small army and there's some units hidden. Either you have units hidden in a forest, or you brought a unit that's going to be very sneaky, like Yugatai or ninjas, or maybe even artillery, and the artillery is hidden. Who knows? But he doesn't see these things, so I was kind of worried about that. That's why, against a very experienced player like Ducky, maybe he'll see this coming, but who knows? I didn't want to overdo it with the ninjas, because my army would look like it's small, and I didn't want to give him that perspective or nothing. I didn't want him to think that. So I only brought 2. I didn't want to overdo it. Agony Sprint gave me this idea of this build. We used this build before, but I didn't bring any guns. He pretty much brought guns. He pretty much brought this build right here, quite similar, and we used 2 similar builds like that against Zarganus and Mats, and I think I posted that battle. If I didn't, then I'll post it, but we did that, we ganked him with our ninjas, and yeah, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to bring the ninjas to disorganize my opponent's forces, and he can see them already, so he knows I have ninjas, so I'm going to throw down stealth mode and just run towards his lines. He's going to move up kinda a little bit more. He's going stationary now. I think he realized just now that I have ninjas, so he's gonna bring back his Cav on this side. I don't know what he's... I guess he wants to try and snipe my Jin, but my Shogatai and my Cav are in the way. This is a nice target too, but I'm not going to immediately charge them. He moved up as my ninjas are charging him, so he's going to get a lot of damage without delivering a full volley or nothing. So his Imperial Infantry and his Imperial Infantry on this side, they're going to sustain a lot of casualties. So as I'm causing all this disorganization, I'm going to send up a cav charge, break his forces on this side. I'm going to slow it down just a little bit. This is for informative purposes. So I'm going to send my cav charge. I realized that his lines weren't disorganized enough, so I sent my cav after this Imperial Infantry. I'm going to pull out later on. Kisho Ninja over here is wrecking up everything. They are pretty much down by half strength. They killed 70, 80 men. It's really not a lot because his Imperial Infantry are really decent at melee. Where is it? Over here, they're kind of fighting. I'm attacking a Red Bear, that's why. The Red Bears are really doing a lot of damage. And I said a lot, like three times. So I broke over here. My Kisho Ninja is vulnerable for cav attacks, but one of his Rebarber Cav are routing. And he's going to take the other and just focus on my Kisho Ninja. On this side, I sent my Black Church's Force to shoot at this Carbine Cav, so they're just taking their sweet time. They will counterfire later on. And on this side, I'm going to send my Cav just to disorganize and everything. He's going to countercharge with his Cav at the rear, so that's really good move by him. He could easily take out my Cav on this side. That's what I was worried about. I was worried that he was going to reform, regroup, and make a new front against me, and I'll have to split up my forces on two or three fronts, but he didn't kite back his guns or nothing. It was kind of late. I sent in my ninjas just to disorganize. I sent in my Shogatai to mop up, and I sent in my cav just to make sure his forces are chaotic, like his formation is chaotic. So I'm gonna press play here. Now you're always wondering, like, what could have he done? But if I had to ask an experienced player, if Zareept or anybody is on currently, then I'll get him on to co-cast with me real quick. But at the moment, we can always ask, what could he have done to counter my build? The thing I could think of at the top of my head is kiting. Just plain kiting. Like, if I heard, oh, hidden units, my, the advisor dude tells you, like, hidden units have appeared and all. Maybe you could kite back. No one's forcing you forward, so just kite back. The other option is to send in your cav. Like, Prussian Prince, there's a new build at the moment. It's like the metagame, as you can say. The metagame that everybody uses if they really want to win. A line spam with, like, 2 to 4 revolver cav will counter almost anything. It's very hard to break, it's very difficult, and it won Prussian Prince the tournament that I was in. I really want to go into full detail about that tournament, about why I didn't, you know, get to the end or anything, but it's kind of weird. But anyway, I sent in the Yariki just to disorganize his Red Bear. They're wavering, and I'm just gonna try and shoot him with my Black Totus Force. I'm gonna take out my cav and try and hit the back of his own, just to quickly break them. You know, you just want to start these individual fights and all, just to quickly break his units, overwhelm them, and finish off his forces. And you can see here, I did have a small build. I was gonna even have a smaller build. My build was only gonna be even smaller if I put upgrades to my Shogunate Guard and Cavalry and my Shogatai, but I couldn't do that. I wanted to bring the ninjas just to disorganize his forces and follow it up with my Shogatai, my guns, my cav, and it pretty much just blitz him. Agony Sprint, this is pretty much his build. He gave me this idea. He was like, oh, don't take 4 ninjas. It's wasteful. That's being wasteful of your funds. Take like 1 or 2. Disorganize his forces. Then send in your Shogatai, mop them out with your cav, and that's how you do it. Here's the results. I deployed 1,170. I lost 552. I killed 1,333. He deployed 1,590. He lost Leet 1,337. Leet amount of losses, 549. He killed. GG, well played, and this is not the end of this cast. I'll be right back to, I'm gonna go back to that point where I took my picture, my screenshot, and I'm gonna cast right there, and I'm gonna ask everyone, what would you do in this situation? We're gonna do the whole what-if scenario, so I'll be right back. Hey, Killerfish, what's up, man? How you been?
Oh, I'm fine, thanks.
Thank you
And
for
you?
joining me.
No problem.
I just got a couple questions from my viewers and all. I'm going to be posting a video about like ninjas, mind games, and all that. When you're in game in the heat of a moment, what do you do when your advisor says, "My lord, stealth units have appeared and all"? What is your first reaction that you would do? Your first couple reactions?
I checked the minimap, I guess.
But what if you don't see anything? Like, what if they went into stealth mode with their ninjas? What do you do then?
Well, most players set their ninjas in the back or on the front. So, if you hear that stealth noise from their ability, you can just pull your matchlocks and range units back and move your attendants forward so you absorb the charge
So kiting is the
from
first
the
option
ninjas.
you would think of.
Yeah, at least. That's what I do most of the times.
Yeah, I agree. That's what pretty much everybody does against me when I bring ninjas. They either send their cav up, like this is for Flawless Samurai, by the way, but Shogun 2 is also a good example because you don't have like those gun cav reliabilities and all that. You don't have that. So Shogun 2 is a good example. Just another question though, before you go. I know you had to go. Let's see. When you start a battle, can you literally just look at a person's build and notice that there is something missing? Like, you know it's 14K matchup, and you notice that he has a bunch of vanilla units, so you know he's missing a bunch of funds, like either something hidden. You notice those kind of things, right?
Yeah, well, it depends on the amount of money you hide. So if you hide just one light calf, I honestly, yeah, I don't re realize that really.
Yeah, you wouldn't notice because it's such a small
Yeah,
thing. Well,
exactly.
in this thing that I'm casting, I bring only two ninjas. I don't want to overdo it because if I bring four, then my opponent might notice that I'm missing a lot of units.
Yeah,
Because that's a lot
that's
of
smart.
funds.
Yeah, exactly. I also think that on maps where forests are also so forests next to your the deployment zone, I think it's even better to bring ninjas because your opponent might think that there is some calf hidden.
Yeah, true. Like, what was that one map where there's forests on two sides? Crossroads, I think it is.
For instance, or Slumbering Settlement.
Is that where those little choke points and key buildings in the center? I'm trying to get my maps correct. Either it's no, it's not Crossroads. I think you're right, Slumbering Settlement. Because there's like two rows of forest on both sides, or Sanriku Ria.
Yeah, exactly. And also Hida Mountains. It's the same actually.
So if you want to bring ninjas and you want to hide your units without being suspected, then go on those maps. So thank you, Killerfish. That was really helpful.
Yep, no problem. See ya.
See you, buddy. Well, there you have it. So in this quick image right here, you can see this point of the battle. Now, it's like, what should he do in this situation? Now, I don't have my units hidden in the forest or nothing. They're ninjas. They don't have to be hidden in the forest. So it's like, what should he do? Let me get my paintbrush real quick. I'm gonna go with red because it's my favorite color. And that's kind of what I'm doing right here. So actually, let me use white because that's his color. Now, he has his revolver cav, his gun cav right here, and I use red. God damn it. He has his revolver cav, his gun cav over here, and here's my ninjas right here. So he can easily just send up his cav, like, at this point, pointed at my ninjas, and easily shoot them as I'm approaching. But that's only if he backs up. Now, if he backs up, that'll give his revolver cav, his carbine cav, enough time to shoot my ninjas and all. But that would leave his cav open for my Shogunate Guard cav, so I would just easily go up and attack him. So what's the correct response? I think he should keep his gun cav behind his guns and his spears. He has spears and everything. His build is so balanced. He has all the tools necessary to do that. It's all about formation. Now, this is the question about formation. People don't think formation is a very important aspect in this game. It's because it's almost like Napoleon to the war. You could split your units across the entire battlefield. So it's really not an option for most people. So what would you do? Spread out? I don't know, against melee, because they could just focus all their melee on one point of your army, so it's really a risk. Maybe he should start his own engagement. Maybe he should start his own initiative attack on this side. I have only cav. So maybe that should give him suspicion that there's going to be a lot of units here. This also gives you an idea where my attack is going to be. You can always mind games. That's how it is. All about mind games. That's what I wanted to talk about. I forgot it. I was talking about mind games with Killerfish, but I forgot to ask about that. But mind games. Like, what would you do to throw your opponent off? I placed my cav on the wings just to make him think I was going to attack on the sides. But that's really not a viable option because he has spears, guns, his own cav on the side, so he shouldn't worry about his flanks. So the only thing that's really vulnerable is his center. He's walking over a hill as well. You can see the hill at this point. Forest. There's a forest here. It's a slope. My ninjas also have a... there's key bonings here too. So both of our armies are kind of in a choke point. But since there's terrain in the center, mine is going to get the full benefit of it. Because he can't shoot what he can't see, of course. And there you have it, mind games. So the best option for him at this point is to fall back.